Hello everyone, welcome to AptiPlace Academy for Civil Services. This is a video on monthly policy review, also known as MPR. And MPR is being released by PRS Legislative Research. And I'll be discussing MPR for the month of September 2021. MPR is very important when it comes to the content, both for prelims as well for the mains examination. It covers all the national important issues pertaining to governance, climate, financial issues, economy issues. So we'll be understanding each important topic that we'll cover in the September edition. So something about PRS Legislative Research. It is an independent research initiative and it supports the member of parliament, member of legislative assemblies and help them in terms of debate and policies making. This is based in New Delhi. For more details, you can refer to the websites also. And those of you who are new to our channel, do not forget to subscribe AptiPlace Academy for Civil Services on YouTube. If you like this video, do not forget to give a thumbs up. So we'll start our session with the first topic, that is Journalist Welfare Scheme. This is something which is important for the people out there who is working with the journalism. And this was long pending and this is a welcome reform that has come in terms of welfare schemes for the journalist. So the Ministry of Information and Broadcasting, they have constituted a committee to review the guideline of the Journalist Welfare Scheme, or is a scheme ki jo chairmanship that is under the Ashok Kumar Tandon. So apart from UPSC, this is something which is important for the examination. Many competitive examination, they can directly ask you about the name, especially state PCS ke examination mein bhi is tarah ke members ke naam puche jate. So the scheme provides financial assistance to journalists and their families in the event of financial hardship. कोई भी ऐसे journalist है, अगर उसकी कोई financial hardship चल रही है, उस time पे ऐसे scheme के through उनको financial assistance दी जाएगी. Now what is the assistance criteria? Basically there are some criteria upon which the assistance would be given. The first is the death of the journalist. If the journalist is died because of any of the reason, the family member would be getting the benefits. Disabilities of the journalist leading to the incapacity of earning and livelihood. ये दूसरी assistance की criteria है. Third is cost of treatment of the major elements. अगर किसी को cancer है या फिर paralytic attacks हैं जिसको paralysis भी कहते हैं, उस तरह की अगर problems हैं तो उसमें भी assistance की criteria रखी गई है. And the last is serious injuries in accidents requiring hospitalization. So these are the four important criteria upon which the assistance would be given to a journalist. Now purpose of the fund ki agar baat kare, so the ministry has noted the review was necessity due to kis kis karan ki wajah se ye zarurat pai gayi there the fund should be there. The first is that there are large number of journalists who have lost their life due to COVID-19. Yeah, this is a fact that we have seen during this pandemic. Second is the widening of definition of working journalist to include both traditional and digital media. Not only digital media, but the people who are associated with print media and any form of journalism would be covered under this fund. Third is the necessity for the consideration of party between the accredited and non-accredited journalist under this scheme. So, दोनों तरह के journalists जो हैं, जो भी accredited हैं, non-accredited हैं, उन दोनों को ये benefits मिलेंगे. Now the other news, that is Niti Aayog reports on urban planning capacity reform. This is something very important for journalist studies paper 3 and paper 2. Dono jagah pe important hai. So we'll understand how this report will help India to build some capacity in terms of urban planning and what are the Niti Aayog take on this also. So the Niti Aayog has released a report that is called Reform in Urban Planning Capacity in India. This is for September 2021. And this report is talking about some important facts. Ke bare mein baat karti hai. So it mentions that during 2011 to 2036, so the growth will be responsible for 73% rise in the total population. Right? So there would be this much rise which we can see in the urban growth. They're mostly concerned about the urban growth. And this brings opportunities to leverage urbanization, जहाँ पे challenges होंगे sustainable growth को promote करने के लिए क्या क्या ऐसी चीजें करने की जरूरत है so that it can substantially have no burden in our other part of the future generations, right? तो एक sustainable development की तरफ urbanizations को increase करने की बात कही गई है. Now some observations and recommendations by the Niti Aayog. सो फर्स्ट इज अबाउट द इंस्टीट्यूशनल स्ट्रक्चर्स, किस तरह के इंस्टीट्यूशनल स्ट्रक्चर्स होने चाहिए। कमेटी ने नोट किया कि बहुत सारे ऐसे स्टेट्स हैं, दे हैव नॉट डिवॉल्व देयर फंड, चाहे वो फंड्स की बात हो, फंक्शंस की बात हो, उनके फंक्शनरीज की बात हो। तो अर्बन प्लानिंग में जिस तरह की ज़रूरतें होनी चाहिए थी, जिस तरह की जो कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन में एनविसाज्ड है अंडर द 74 कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल एक्ट, दैट वॉज नॉट एक्चुअली इम्प्लीमेंटेड, विच हैज़ लेड टू द पुअर प्लानिंग, पुअर फंक्शनिंग ऑफ अर्बन गवर्नेंस। नाउ दिस हैज लेड टू द लैक ऑफ अकाउंटेबिलिटी, काउजिंग डिलेज इन द रिसोर्सेज एंड रिसोर्स वेस्टेज। सो ये कुछ इंपॉर्टेंट फैक्टर है, कुछ इंस्टीट्यूशनल स्ट्रक्चर्स हैं जो कि फ्लॉज हमें बताती है उस पर काम करने की जरूरत है। नाउ द कमिटी रिकमेंडेड सम ऑफ द इंपॉर्टेंट रिकमेंडेशंस कमिंग फ्रॉम द नीति आयोग कमिटी। सो फर्स्ट दे सेड एम्पावरिंग द मेयर एंड स्टैंडिंग कमेटी टू मेक मोर इफेक्टिव, जहाँ पे अर्बन प्लानिंग और उसके मैनेजमेंट पे ध्यान देने की ज़रूरत है। सेकेंड इज रिक्रूटिंग द अर्बन प्लानर, जहाँ पे जो एडवाइजर्स होंगे, फेलोअर्स होंगे, उनको रिक्रूट की जाएगी मेयर ऑफिस में, चाहे वो स्टेट्स हों या फिर यूनियन टेरिटरीज हों। द थर्ड इज कमिशनाइजिंग हाई पावर कमेटी, जो कि रिव्यू करेगी पूरे अर्बन प्लान के स्ट्रक्चर्स को, हाउ द अर्बन गवर्नेंस स्ट्रक्चर वुड बी गवर्न इन इंडिया वुड बी डन बाय द हाई पावर कमेटी। Now, master plans की अगर बात करें, how the master plan in the longer run, so the committee noted that though most state have a legal power to prepare and notify master plans, 65% of their urban settlement in India do not have any master plans, right? Master plan की बात कीजिए, master plan is something which will give you in a longer run. ये long term measures होती है जहाँ पर master plan की जाती है, but कुछ ऐसे स्टेट्स और यूटीज हैं जिनमें 65% के पास कोई भी अभी तक अर्बन प्लानिंग या मास्टर प्लानिंग नहीं है। टू इंश्योर द प्लान्ड अर्बनाइजेशंस, द कमिटी हैज रिकमेंडेड इंप्लीमेंटिंग 5-year सेंट्रल सेक्टोरल स्कीम, जिसमें 500 हेल्दी सिटीज प्रोग्राम को इंक्लूड की जानी है। द स्कीम वुड ऑल्सो एम टू अचीव हेल्थ सेंट्रिक प्लानिंग, जहाँ पे कन्वर्ज की जाएगी स्पेशल प्लानिंग को पब्लिक हेल्थ, सोशो इकोनॉमिक डेवलपमेंट, इन तीनों चीज़ों को इंट्रिकेट करने की बात कही गई है। नाउ द अदर न्यूज, दैट इज रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी सर्टिफिकेट मैकेनिज्म। दिस इज समथिंग विच इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन टर्म्स ऑफ मेकिंग इंडिया मोर इनक्लाइंड टूअर्ड इट्स कमिटमेंट ऑफ रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी। तो मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ पावर ने अनाउंस किया है कि रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी जो सर्टिफिकेट है उसके मैकेनिज्म में कुछ चेंजेस की जाएगी, एंड दिस मैकेनिज्म नोटेड बाय द सेंट्रल इलेक्ट्रिसिटी रेगुलेटरी कमीशंस, विच विल इश्यूज द रेगुलेशन with effect after the proposed changes. तो changes के बाद सारी regulations जो है watchdog है, that would be the Central Electricity Regulatory Commissions. Now क्या है ये certificates on how they are making the changes? So REC की अगर बात करें, Renewable Energy Certificate, it's a market-based instrument, right? जो कि promote करेगी renewable energy को, and it would also facilitate the compliances with the Renewable Purchase Obligations. जो RPO है, जो obligations है, उसको उसके उस पर कंप्लाइंसेस में मदद करने के लिए ये रखी गई है। एंड द आरपीओ रेफर्स टू अ मैंडेट फॉर डिस्ट्रीब्यूशंस ऑफ लाइसेंस टू प्रोक्योर सर्टेन शेयर ऑफ द एनर्जी रिक्वायरमेंट, राइट? जो भी एनर्जी रिक्वायरमेंट है, चाहे वो रिन्यूएबल रिसोर्सेज से हो या जो भी रिन्यूएबल फॉर्म ऑफ एनर्जी है, उसमें ये मैंडेट रखी गई। REC इज इशूड टू रिन्यूएबल पावर जनरेटर्स, दैट इज REC होल्डर्स विच में बी ट्रेडेड। सो इसमें ऑप्शंस रखे गए, फर्दर इट कैन बी ट्रेडेड ऑल्सो। वंस द REC रिप्रेजेंटर आर 1 megawatt और 1 hour एनर्जी इज जनरेटेड फ्रॉम द रिन्यूएबल रिसोर्सेज। और REC की अगर बात करें, दिस में बी ब्राउड बाय द एंटायर फॉर्म ऑफ REC होल्डर टू फुलफिल देयर RPO. RPO अगेन स्टैंड फॉर रिन्यूएबल परचेज ऑब्लिगेशन। सो दिस इज मोर इन टर्म्स ऑफ प्रोवाइडिंग अ सस्टेनेबिलिटी टू द इंस्ट्रूमेंट वेर इट कैन बी ट्रेडेड इन फ्यूचर, एंड एट द सेम टाइम इट कॉल्ड फॉर मोर इन टर्म्स ऑफ ऑब्लिगेशन दैट इज देयर फॉर इंडिया इन द इंटरनेशनल फोरम लाइक पेरिस क्लाइमेट चेंज, और अभी रिसेंट में जो COP26 होनी है उसके तरफ की ये तैयारी भी आप कह सकते हैं। नाउ व्हाट आर द प्रपोज चेंजेस, वैलिडिटी की अगर बात करें, जो भी रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी सर्टिफिकेट्स होंगे, तो करेंटली इसकी वैलिडिटी है दैट इज फॉर 1095 अप्रॉक्सीमेटली 3 years, एंड REC होल्डर्स इज रिक्वायर्ड टू सेल द REC विद इन द वैलिडिटी ऑफ द पीरियड। नाउ प्रमोशंस ऑफ न्यू RE टेक्नोलॉजी, जो रिवाइज मैकेनिज्म है, इट विल प्रोवाइड फॉर इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी मल्टीप्लायर सिस्टम, जहाँ पे RE टेक्नोलॉजी को प्रमोट की जाएगी। दिस मीन्स द हायर नंबर ऑफ REC वुड बी इंट्रोड्यूस्ड इन अ टेक्नोलॉजी, राइट? सो दिस इज वॉट द गवर्नमेंट इज ट्राइंग टू इनकॉर्पोरेट in terms of renewable energy technology via the renewable energy certificates. Another news, that is National Road Safety Board. This is something which is very important and also important for your case study, right? Many times in general studies paper 4, the case study sections pertain to road safety. Ministry of Road Transport and Highway ne ek nayi road safety board banane ki baat ki. This is under the provision of Motor Vehicle Act 1988. And the National Road Safety Board would advise central as well as the state government in aspects related to road safety or traffic management. So, dono tarah se kaam karegi, ye central ko bhi assist karegi. At the same time, it will assist the state government in terms of road safety and road management. Aur board jo hai, this will consist of 4 to 8 full-time members, jahan pe ek chairman honge. This would be appointed by the central government. And again, a select committee would be there whose recommendation is would be taken. Now, kuch features ki agar baat kare road safety boards ki. So, first is the term and condition of services. Jo board members honge, unke kya kya terms condition hai. The expert is for one or more year in the field of transport engineering, road safety, urban planning and law. To jo board, jin board member ko bhi appoint ki jayegi, wo is field se hone chahiye. And all board members including the chairman will have a 3-year term. So, this is again factually important for your prelims also, and they will be eligible for reappointment for one more year. So, only one more year can be extended to the members, right? And the upper age limit for the office is 62 years for the members and 65 years for the chairman. Now, duties ki agar baat kare, there are specific responsibility which is being provided in terms of road safety, jahan pe innovations, adopting a new technology, regulating vehicular traffic, ये सारी चीज़ों पर ध्यान दी जाएगी. उसके अलावा कुछ जो major recommendations हैं, जो major duties हैं, that include standards of road safety, traffic management and road construction in hilly regions, regulation framework for commercial signage and billboards. Second is conducting research activities for improving the crash investigations. Or third, promoting the provisions of immediate assistance to the victim of road accident without expectations of reward, right? So, jo bhi good humanitarians ki jo values hai, usko incorporate karne ki bhi baatein kahi gayi, and this is something which is required as a moral obligation. As a citizen of this country, we should have some obligations to our citizen also. Now, technical working group banane ki baat ki gayi hai. There would be a technical constituted a technical working group like traffic management, crash investigations, forensic and driver skilling testings. Now the other news, that is Tribunal Conditions Service Rule 2021. Now this is something which is again important for General Studies Paper 2. So Tribunal Service Conditions ki agar baat kare, it was notified by Ministry of Finance under the Tribunal Reform Act 2021. Aur ye act abolish karti hai existing appellate bodies ko and transfer their functions mainly to the high courts. So now all the function and jurisdiction would be lying within the concerned High Court. Further, it empowers the central government to notify and disqualify the tribunal members on certain terms and condition of their services. Isko lekar ke Supreme Court ne bhi apprehensions ki thi, but again, this is something which government has affirmed on the decision. Features of the notified rule ki agar baat kare, reappointment ki baat ki gayi hai. The rule specifies that jo selected candidate honge for the appointment in a tribunal, an additional weightage must be given to the person with an experience in the tribunal. A past performance ko dekhte hue candidate ki uske tribunal mein uski appointment ki jayegi, and he can also be decided with the reappointment procedures. Inquiry of a complaint which has to be taken by the tribunal. So written complaint jani hoti hai chairman ke paas, and he will this has to come from the central government or from the state government from the preliminary scrutiny. Based on the scrutiny, the government will refer the complaint to the concerned search and select committee. Or committee delegate karegi ek person ko jo conduct karenge is tarah ke inquiry. And such person should be, jo bhi khas karke jo select committee mein jo bhi member include kiye jayenge, he should be a judge of the Supreme Court or the Chief Justice of High Court, and inquiries on whomsoever has been the part of any basically inquiry committees. Second would be the judges of High Court for inquiry against the any members, right? So this is the criteria which has mentioned again the inquiry of a complaint. Now currently 2021 ki jo act hai, that has challenged in the Supreme Court as it includes the provision of ordinance which were struck down by the court itself. So Supreme Court ne isko struck down kiya hai. And for comparison of the compliances of the rules within the Supreme Court ruling. So let's see, will there be any changes after the intervention of the Supreme Court, or government is going to implement this? So still there's a kind of suspicion and ambiguous which still exist. Now IFC constituted Committee on Sustainable Finance. Sustainable finance is something which is very important. This started during the Paris climate change, and recently also between India and US, we are more inclined towards the sustainable finance. There is a $100 million deal which has already been signed between India and US. I have discussed that in our daily news analysis. If you have not watched it, do check out the Saturday editions. You'll get that, right? Now, the International Financial Services Centers Authority constituted an expert committee under the chairmanship of C.K. Misra to develop a financial hub. And this is more towards a sustainable financial hub. And the committee would be studying the current regulatory practices of sustainable finances across the international financial jurisdictions. Kya hai sustainable finance? Ye involve karegi raising the financial resources of climate change, adaptation and mitigation, and it will also recommend the roadmap to develop the sustainable financial hub at IFSC. Our committee submit karegi apne reports ko within 3 months from the date of first meeting. So the time duration which has been given by the government to the committee would be 3 months to submit its first report. Now, framework for the social exchange stock. This is an initiative by SEBI. We'll understand this also. So the Security Exchange Board of India have approved the creation for Social Stock Exchange, SSE, for the fund by raising the social enterprises. This is something which is very important for your prelims examination. SSE ki baat kare, it will be a separate segment of the existing stock exchanges. So alag se isko maintain karne ki baat ki gayi hai. And entities may participate in SSE that include NGO, jitne bhi non-profit organizations hain. And for the profit, social enterprises can be the part of this SSE. Now, eligible non-profit organization may raise fund, chahe wo equity ke form mein ho, equity, bond, mutual funds, social impact fund, development impact bond can register with the SSE. Or audit of the impact will mandate the social enterprises to raise fund registered on the SSE. So these are the criteria which has to be fulfilled, and this is mandated by the Security and Exchange Board of India. Now, IRDAI guideline for the cyber assurance. So, jo hamari insurance apex body hai, that is IRDAI, they have issued guideline on the product structure of the cyber insurance. We have seen the cyber crime which is ongoing in our country, and the level has exceeded. So, accordingly, the organization are also boosting up, brushing up their skills in terms of cyber insurance. So the cyber insurance mean an assurance for businesses, for individual against the cyber crime. Aur ye jo guideline hogi, it seeks to address the gap in cyber insurance coverages. Kuch key recommendations ki agar baat kare, to classifications ki gayi hai cyber attacks pe. To IRDA ne note kiya hai, only targeted intrusions into a person's system can be classified as an attack. Agar kisi individual ke computers pe software ko hack ki jati hai, so that can be considered as a cyber attack. And it recommends that the insurers may be classified any form of unauthorized access to as a cyber attack. Koi bhi unauthorized transactions ho, extra ki activities ho, that would be considered as a cyber attack. Now, extent of insurance coverage, IRDA ne note kiya hai that cyber insurance policy in India do not cover SIM jacking, jahan pe unauthorized control hoti hai phone pe, card cloning, skimming, whenever the cloning of the card is also been done, breaking jahan pe damage ki jaati hai computer ka hardware ko, in sare cheezon ko is not covered under the insurance cover, right? And it recommends that insurance may offer coverage for such losses. Other key recommendations include FIR for the cyber frauds, right? So filling of the first information report is necessary when filing a claim for a cyber insurance. So koi bhi cyber claim ya karke fraud agar hoti hai kisi individual ke sath, to uske liye FIR mandatory hogi. This would be a necessary part. And IRDAI noted that filing FIR has a hassle free for individual, it should be hassle free for individual. It recommended that the claims up to 5,000 rupees for an issuer may be considered as an e-complaint lodged by the National Cyber Crime Reporting Portal, right? So this type of awareness is very essential considering the fact in today's 21st generation, cyber fraud is flourishing so much. Now, the other news, that is SEBI introduced T+1 rolling settlement system. So the Security Exchange Board of India has introduced T+1 settlement system as an optional basis. और ये T+1 settlement जो cycle है खास करके transactions की, this would be executed in a single day, like one day would be there for the settlement. अभी अगर present की बात करें, present SEBI follow T+2 cycle, that which allow transactions to be settled within 2 days after the executions. Now a stock may offer T+1 settlement cycle on any script, किसी भी stocks पे applicable होगी, and the stock exchange will have to give advance notice at least 1 month regarding the change in their settlement cycle. अगर कोई भी stock exchange अपनी settlement cycle को change करती है, तो उसको prior information देनी होगी SEBI को. And after the options, T+1 settlement system for a script or a stock exchange will be mandatory continue for a minimum of 6 period. अगर एक बार changes की जाती है किसी भी cycle में, तो उसको उन्हें 6 month तक continue रखना पड़ेगा. उससे पहले वो change नहीं कर पाएंगे. Thereafter, it can revert T+2 cycle by giving 1 month advance notice, and whenever they want to change it, 1 month ki advance notice deni hogi. So in total 7 month gap can be there between any cycle. Now Covervax granted approval for the clinical trial. So the Drug Controller General of India have approved Covervax the conducting phase 3 trials. ये adults के लिए की गई है, जहाँ पे phase 2 और phase 3 के जो pediatrics trial हैं children और adolescents में भी की जानी है. The Cervarix is a COVID-19 vaccine developed by the Biological E Limited with support from the Department of Biotechnology, right? So this is Corbivax, is a kind of vaccine that is something which would be very important, and it would be the part of all the vaccine that is being given to citizen of this country. This is being inoculated to all other citizen. So Corbivax ke bare mein aap yaad rakhein, this is something which is important. Now currently और कौन कौन से ऐसे वैक्सीन से जो इंडिया में अप्रूव किए गए हैं और वो इमरजेंसी यूज ऑथोराइजेशन के थ्रू दिए जा रहे हैं, दैट इंक्लूड कोविड शील्ड. मोस्ट ऑफ द नंबर ऑफ द वैक्सीन दैट वी हैव गॉट इज फ्रॉम द कोविड शील्ड. सेकेंड इज कोवैक्सीन, स्पूतनिक वी, mRNA-1273 जिसको मॉडर्ना वैक्सीन के नाम से भी जाना जाता है, जेंसिन एंड जाइकोट डी. दिस इज मोस्टली फॉर चिल्ड्रेन ऑल्सो. और ये वैक्सीन जो है ये एडमिनिस्टर की जा रही है ऑल पर्सन अबव 18 ऑफ एज, और जाइकोव डी को एडमिनिस्ट्रेंस की गई है, अप्रूवल मिली है फॉर द चिल्ड्रन हु इज एज ऑफ 12 आल्सो 12 एंड अबव. एंड इन मई 2021 कोवैक्सीन हैव आल्सो ग्रांटेड अप्रूवल फॉर द पेडियाट्रिक ट्रायल्स फॉर द चिल्ड्रंस बिटवीन 2 to 18 ईयर ऑफ एज, राइट? सो वेरी सून फ्रॉम नवंबर वी कैन सी दैट द चिल्ड्रन इन इंडिया वुड आल्सो बी गेटिंग वैक्सीनेटेड. नाउ दिस वाज ऑल अबाउट this month PRS editions. We have lot more other initiatives like daily news editorial analysis, IS Gazetted magazine, fortnight current affairs, PIB compilations. You can watch all other initiatives, and this initiative is meant to help you to sail through this journey of civil services. So if you like this video, do not forget to give thumbs up. We'll meet again in the next video. Thank you so much for watching.